Pleasure to be joined now by Kyle Yeomans. He is a TV radio host, covers all things Dallas Cowboys. A lot of headlines coming out of training camp down your way, Kyle. Let's start with the big headline, the health of Dak Prescott. Mike McCarthy saying, hopefully, you know, he'll be ready, but might not see any preseason action. What is the latest on his health?
Yeah, I think that's exactly what the thought process is around Dak Prescott, is one of caution is the best way to say it. And that's really kind of been the mantra of this coaching staff and this training staff ever since he did suffer that shoulder strain in the first padded practice of training camp. So they want to keep things very conservative, very careful along the way. And in doing so, he said that he's probably not going to see any preseason playing time, which normally I think for a starting quarterback heading into his sixth year in the NFL is not significant. I think it's more significant in the fact that he hasn't played any meaningful snaps, any live action snaps, really, since week five of 2020 when he suffered the ankle injury. So overall, it's a bit concerning going into week one when you're facing a team like Tampa Bay in the season opener. It's going to be rough, but I think Dak Prescott and this coaching staff are pretty confident in his ability, even without seeing those live reps.
I think you're right. I know the message before camp was, hey, let's try to get him as many reps as possible coming back from the ankle injury. And so I imagine that this is something of a concern. You know, being there in Dallas, is the consensus just, hey, this might be a little bit rocky first couple games of the season if we can't get him the reps that we need in camp, but we have to do what's best physically for him?
I think there's probably a part to that. I think there really is confidence in the fact that he will come in and play up to the level that you expect from a starting quarterback, and especially a highly paid starting quarterback in the NFL. But I think there is a little bit of concern just because of the rust that he's going to get knocked off. And I think a part of that comes from a mental standpoint and having to go into live game action, not knowing what it is like to run away from a chasing defensive end or have to roll out of the pocket against live reps. So I think there is that mindset. But luckily for the Cowboys and really for Dak himself, is he's been through this kind of adversity in the past. I mean, he's talked about it previously, the injuries that he's had to go through, maybe not during his NFL career, but early in life and having to kind of overcome adversity. You saw it in the first scene of Hard Knocks. He said, hey, I've got scars. I'm used to having scars. And that's something that's not new to him overall. And I think he's one of the more mentally strong quarterbacks in the NFL. And I think if you were going to pick a guy to have to go into that situation, that a lot of it is mental, going against a team like Tampa Bay for their first live reps in almost an entire calendar year, I think he's the one that you would want to do it with.
How does Amari Cooper look to you in the limited time that you've been able to observe him?
He's looked good. Got back out to practice as soon as the Cowboys got back to Frisco. Did not participate in any of the team drills in Oxnard, but was running routes and was looking good. And basically he said that everything has felt good for a while. He's just having to go back into the route tree a little bit. And he's had a couple of surgeries on that ankle to make sure that everything is cleaned up down there from a lingering issue that bothered him throughout 2020. And he says, man, now I don't have any of that. It's basically bone swelling that has to go down. And now that they've gotten back to Frisco, he did participate in Monday's team drills. He participated in Wednesday's team drills as well. So overall, he is getting back into the mix, and he says he's close to 100%, if not 100%, and is looking forward to kind of pushing himself a little bit to get back to that full Amari Cooper that we're used to seeing.
I know defensively there's been question marks for this team. I'm looking at 26-year-old Keanu Neal, who's making the transition to linebacker. Is he a player in your mind that could be an X factor for them defensively?
I think he definitely can be, and he showed that in the first drive against Arizona this past Friday. I mean, preseason game number two, drive number two for Keanu Neal, and he forces a fumble. He goes in and he pokes the ball away. That's the kind of player that he was when healthy as a safety for Dan Quinn in Atlanta. That's why Dan Quinn was so adamant to get him here and get him to Dallas, is because he is a ball hawk. He's somebody that does make those impact type of plays. And you mentioned the switch to linebacker. Dan Quinn jokingly with us with the media in Oxnard said, I tricked him into thinking he was a safety when he was really playing linebacker in Atlanta. Now he actually has the title to work with it. And he's filled out. He's filled up about 15 more pounds. He looks bigger. He looks like the role of a linebacker, or at least the body frame, body type of a linebacker. I think there's a lot of excitement from what he can bring from, yes, a ball hawking standpoint and a rotational standpoint from that defense to provide multiple looks for Dan Quinn.
Which other young players have really stood out to you as you've observed practice?
So the easy answer here is going to be first round pick Micah Parsons. I mean, he has been everything that he was advertised to be coming out of Penn State. Of course, he was the 12th overall pick in April's NFL draft. And he comes out and, my goodness, he plays everywhere on the field. He plays back in coverage. He can rush the passer. He can blitz up the middle. He can play the Mike linebacker. He can play outside. He has been all over the place. And the speed, I think, is something that was very underrated, the speed in his coverage ability, both underrated coming out of school, because at least throughout camp, we've seen him cover guys like CeeDee Lamb over the middle, Blake Jarwin as a tight end, Dalton Schultz as well. And he's had multiple interceptions. He's had pass breakups. He had the fumble recovery against the Steelers in the Hall of Fame game. He has been all over the field. And a lot of the reason why he was so highly touted coming out of Penn State was because, well, he finds the football, and he's done that already on multiple occasions throughout training camp and then also through practices as well, and even into the preseason. So there's a lot of excitement around Micah Parsons. I mentioned the position flex that Keanu Neal can bring to the table for Dan Quinn. Micah Parsons can do that times almost four or five from what he can do from a linebacker standpoint.
Just overall, as you listen to Mike McCarthy, you get the sense that, you know, obviously Dak Prescott being the main headline, but the training camp in terms of reps or getting guys what they need, it might have just been a bit of a patchwork deal, like I think some other teams are going through. I mean, you being there covering the team as closely as you do, do you get the sense that they have been able to accomplish what they've needed to accomplish in training camp, or are the first couple games of the regular season going to continue to be a work in progress for this team?
I think this team still has a long way to go, and there is some optimism around Mike McCarthy and what they've been able to do. I mean, he said he was very, very happy. I mean, he put two varies in there whenever it came to talking about the install process of really learning the foundations of both sides of the football for this squad. And there's a lot of young guys, but there are some sprinkled in veterans back and forth that really do have a big time impact. I mean, they bring in guys like Carlos Watkins and Brent Urban and the aforementioned Keanu Neal, Malik Hooker, DeMonte KZ, a lot of guys, all of those defensive, I should add, that have come in and been vocal leaders for Mike McCarthy and for Dan Quinn and everybody in between to make sure that everything is learned from a foundational standpoint, because that was the issue in 2020. It seemed like it never really caught grasp, especially on that side of the football throughout the year. Mike McCarthy, very happy there. I think offensively, it's been a little bit more of a struggle because of some of the injuries. Of course, not having your quarterback out there throwing in practice and participating in team drills as much as Dak Prescott would like to be, it definitely brings down your offense a little bit because the receivers don't have a rhythm. You aren't able to really run the ball effectively in practice anyways because of the professional thud is what they call it. There's no takedowns, no tackles on a running back or even a wide receiver for that matter in practice. So the effective work hasn't really been there for the offense. And so I think that's going to be a little bit more of a ways to go in Mike McCarthy's mind moving forward, which is a good thing because I think if you would ask anybody, the majority of the talent on this roster lies on the offensive end.
How many games do you expect them to win? Early prediction.
Ooh, early prediction. That's a tough one. You're putting me on the spot. I think this team would be disappointed in not winning the NFC East. I think that's the goal right now, is to go and win the NFC East. And I certainly think, at least on paper, if everything comes back, Dak Prescott's healthy, your offensive line is healthy again, you're going to have a really good shot to do so. And I think in order to win the NFC East this year, it's not going to be a losing record. I don't think 2020 is going to repeat itself in this division. I think the Washington football team is going to have some something to say about it. I think the Giants are even on the rise a bit in the division. So I think it'll be much more tightly contested between those rivals. But I think the Cowboys probably need 11 wins in a 17 game season to get that win or to get that division title. So I'm going to say 11 wins, 11-6 for the Cowboys this year, which is bold because they went 6-10 a year ago. I know a lot of people probably are saying, oh my gosh, Cowboys expectations high again, but that's really the mindset going into the year.
Feels like for America's team, the expectations are always high. And I think the Cowboys fan would maybe take that prediction. Kyle, thank you so much for being with us. We'll check back in with you during the regular season, if you don't mind, once we get a better sense of what Dak Prescott's able to contribute. Big question mark right now in the NFL.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me.
You bet.